Well, the Penguins are taking the Stanley Cup on a tour of Pittsburgh, and tonight they will be making a stop at PNC Park. The Pirates will honor the Pens during the pregame ceremonies. The Penguins also brought the Cup to PNC Park in 2009. Last year, though, the Pirates are on the road when the Pens won. Now, that Cup will be in downtown Pittsburgh tomorrow, of course, for the Penguins Victory Parade. About 500,000 people are expected to line the streets from Liberty Avenue to Point State Park. Lynn Hayes Freeland is live this evening with what you need to know if you're going to come into town for the parade. Lynn?
So, Stacey, the big question is tonight, how do you plan a party for 500,000 people? Well, obviously, it takes a lot of preparation. Now, all over town tonight, you can see the horses are already in place. There are guardrails all over town. Even no parking signs. There's a couple of streets that you cannot park on after 6 o'clock this morning, tomorrow morning, including here on Commonwealth Place, the Boulevard of the Allies. And the other thing you have to keep in mind, if you are one of the 500,000 people coming to the party, you better bring some water. In fact, the city says they want everyone to have at least 3 bottles of water because it's supposed to be at least 80 degrees when the party starts. In case you haven't heard, Pittsburgh is hosting a Stanley Cup victory parade in the heart of downtown, and there may be as many as 500,000 people here.
We are expecting people to come from all around the region.
Maneuvering the parade area will take planning because of traffic and to get a good view, so get here early.
We were scouting it out earlier today. We were up by the steel building, so we're probably going to watch it up there, try to get a little bit of shade.
Shade will be important if you can find it. It's supposed to be hot and humid during the height of the parade. This parking lot along the Boulevard of the Allies is a popular viewing spot, and you can watch from here even if you haven't parked here. Office rooftops and windows are another option too, if you can get access.
My building is right on the parade route, and I have a window view on the first floor.
Traffic in the heart of downtown will pretty much come to a halt. The actual parade route will be shut down to traffic at 9 a.m. Roads will reopen as the parade passes through. This will also affect buses in downtown, so make alternate plans for getting around. Maybe walk. But remember, it's going to be a scorcher.
We need people to stay hydrated. Try not to get too excited about this championship win because we don't want them passing out.
You will be surrounded by thousands of fans, well-wishers, friends, and folks who have traveled hours to get here, all with one goal. Well, sort of.
I want to make some poser and then tell you, cross me, I want to marry you.
And I'm guessing that's not the only marriage proposal that's going to be offered up here tomorrow. Last thing, the city reminds folks, even though they love to wear those Pens jerseys, it's just going to be too hot tomorrow to wear a heavy sports jersey. So think about a light-colored, light fabric shirt. Reporting live at Point State Park, I'm Lynn Hayes Freeland, KDKA TV News.